Gosh, in front of the camera on the stage, Gloria Reuben does such great work, and this is really important. It's a new book about siblings and sibling loss. It's called My Brother's Keeper. Nice to have you here.
Nice to be back.
What prompted you to do this? You write about two brothers who've passed away.
Yes, my two brothers, David and Dennis, passed away unexpectedly. My younger brother, David, many years ago, which was the impetus for me to move from Toronto to LA. And my brother, Dennis, passed away suddenly a few years ago. And it was through writing in my journal, frankly, trying to process all of the emotions and the experiences and, you know, the stages of grief, if you will, and what happens next. And so I started writing, all of a sudden, you know, instinctively, the journal entries kind of started to shape themselves into these essays. And then a few years ago, I was reading through some of them, and I thought, why don't I shape this into a book? How does this feel if I lay these out in a certain order and then include as a narrative to kind of weave everything together, certain aspects of my home life and present day situations and how far I've healed, how much more healing needs to continue, and you know, remembering them with a great deal of love and happiness and loss, and I miss them. And so it's everything.
I tell you what, people I think have explored the loss of a child,
yes,
one's parents. I don't know that I've never ever encountered anything about siblings.
Yes.
And then, this is going to sound silly, your younger brother who passed away unexpectedly at a very young age.
Yes.
Your other brother was in his 60s. Was that less bad?
No, it's both really. Mm. My little brother David sadly took his own life a few days before his 22nd birthday. Mm. And my brother Dennis passed away 2 weeks before his 60th birthday. And Dennis and I grew extremely close, particularly after David's death. So, you know, everybody knows that loss and death is a part of life, of course. I don't want to, you know, sometimes I think we're afraid to really talk about it, to really go in there and talk about all of it. And, you know, people say, oh, you know, you must be over it. And there's, well, you should be over it by now.
Right.
Yeah. No, I'm sorry. Love is everlasting. And it continues to flow. And my love for them flows through me in everything that I do, from this book to music to acting, all of it. They are a part of me and will continue to be. And I think, again, anyone who's experienced, and we all have in one way or another, a deep loss, mm-hmm. Gives us strength and at the same time opens our hearts. And we have to be vulnerable and strong at the same time. I think so. That's what life's about, yes? Mm-hmm. Being open and vulnerable and still being able to carry through and help others in the process.
Speaking of carrying through, role on Mr. Robot.
Yes.
People have such a great response to that show.
Yes.
What is happening in this final season?
I can't tell you.
Yeah. Okay. Wow.
I know.
Yeah.
But
do
all
you
I have
even
to
know?
Say is, oh,
okay.
Yeah, I know.
All right.
All I can say is that it is extraordinary, from the storytelling, as we all know, to the direction of Sam Esmail, of course, who created the show, to Rami Malek's, you know, he is just unbelievably a beautiful person and an extraordinarily talented man, to Todd Campbell's visual, our director of photography. It's unforgettable.
Wow. Wow. Well, here we're gonna look at a clip. Let's take a look. Watch this.
Krista.
Give me a second.
Sure.
I've tried calling you.
Elliot, I thought I made myself clear.
Yeah, I got your letter. I just wanted to talk to you.
You know that can't happen. I explained that in the letter as politely as I could.
I don't understand. I'm doing better. I'm finally talking to Mr. Robot, just like you always said I should.
We cannot have contact anymore. Do you understand that?
I just want you to know that I'm finally making some real progress.
I don't feel safe around you.
Whoa. Wow.
So now if anyone has not seen this series at all, then you know, I'm sorry because you really missed out. But no, just from the first episode in the first season, all of that one scene will make sense. Mm. You know, I play Elliot's, Rami's psychiatrist.
Right.
And let me just say that I knew that this would be the clip because it's already aired. But as we continue with the season, you know, starting this Sunday night is the next episode.
Oh, wow.
We'll tell you this. The book that we've talked about, My Brother's Keeper, will drop on November the 19th. Mr. Robot, brand new, Sundays on the USA Network. Nice to see you this morning.
Thank you. Gloria, thank you. Thanks, Gloria.